on transit to Saudi Arabia. Currently, I'm at the JKA airport. I'm heading to Saudi Arabia to go and work in the Al Marai Dairy Company. Where I'm going, they're going to provide for us accommodation. We're going to be given food in that company, and we're going to be paid well. Competitive Manpower International Limited has been given a slot of 10,000 Kenyan youths to go and work in that dairy company.
Naitwa Winston Makandi Kubai. Nimetokea maeneo ya Meru, lakini ni mkaaji hapa Nairobi. Na hii biashara unapoiona ni jasho kutokea ngas 2014 mpaka 2021. Nimekuwa maeneo mbalimbali, Saudia, Lebanon na Qatar. Na si peke yake, huyu ndiye mzee wangu. Aitwa Stephen Mudhomi.
Naitwa Stephen Mudhomi.
Na
pande mwingine kuna nani
huko? Kuna sister anaitwa Lucy. Na sister mwingine yuko Saudia, na sister mwingine yuko askari Migori. She's my sister, so naona customers there. So niambie watu wenye wanaenda ngaf, wasifikirie ngaf azi ni kuna mateso huko. Mtu aenda akakamua afanye kazi akijua kenye kimemtoa Kenya. Kenya kimekupeleka huko ni kazi. Ndio maana umetoka Kenya ukaenda kwa wenyewe. So wafanye kazi vizuri na waweze waseme huko kuna mateso, waweke wengine uoga ya kwenda kujitafutia riziki ya kesho.
For me, I have made six figures since I went to Saudi Arabia. I have made money there, and the money that I earn there, I cannot earn that money here. Because as a technical person, when working there, the money that I get paid there is equivalent to a package, to a manager's package in Kenya. You earn depending on the workload. There is a time you will get, because when I went there, I went as a junior technician. Now, when I left there, I left as a senior technician. So the money, the package that I got there is more better than the package that I got 5 years ago. Remember, in Kenya, you can drink as much as you want. When you go there, drinking is prohibited. Don't drink there. In Kenya, we also don't allow prostitution. It's not allowed. Actually, people do it, but it's not legal. So what makes you think that when you go to work in a foreign country, Islamic country, you'll do prostitution there and then end up in safe hands? So let all of us behave so that we can continue earning. Those of us who have chance to work there, please let us behave so that we don't destroy we don't spoil the future of our generation, our next future generation, because many people will still remember that our population is still growing and still there are no more jobs. So what do you think will happen in the next 10-15 years in Kenya? There'll be no jobs. So don't let the government block others to go and work there. If you don't want to go to work there, if you are alcoholic, you are addicted, you cannot stay there without alcohol, please stay here. If you are prostitution, you cannot stay there without being a prostitute, stay in Kenya. I want to talk about those Kenyans complaining there. Najua ushaona wa Kenya wengine wakiwa kwa room wamefungiwa na complain, wanasema government iwasaidie. What I can say, those Kenyans wanakuwaga wamefanya makosa, wametoroka, majority wanakuwaga wametoroka kwa employer. Wakitoroka kwa employer, normally wanaga hii. Si visa ni gama. Ukienda huko unapewa hii. Ukipatana na police, if you are got with any police on the way, first thing the police will ask you, when ni gama? When ni gama? You have to remove your residence. You have to prove that you are allowed to stay in Saudi Arabia. If you don't have a proof, so they put you in custody. You stay there for as long as, sometimes they put you there to deport you. Sometimes they delay to deport you. You have to get money from your people to pay ticket, because the government sometimes get tired to pay tickets for people who are running away. So what we can say, wa Kenya, if you have gone there, umeenda kufanya kazi, tabia za enzi ulikuwa unafanya Kenya, tuache Kenya. If you go there, do like they do. That is why they say, if you go to Rome, do like Romans do. Awezi enda pale, utafute mtu wa mboga na hayuko, wa kuongea na yeye. Tukienda pale, we go there to work. Diligently, do your job as you agreed with your employer, come back home, support your family.
As a team here, you can see I'm living with my colleagues. We are going to work for Almarai Dairy Company in the position of technical helper. We'll first have just to thank God, because it has not been easy to go through this process. It has been a hectic process actually to get where we are. We've gone through the medical process. We've gone through thorough vetting, yeah, so that we can have the chance to travel to Saudi Arabia. I know most of the guys here are so excited as I am. Yeah, because for me it's my first chance to be at the JKIA. Yeah, living out of the country, and I know there's good opportunity working with the Almarai Dairy Company. We are going outside here to look for opportunities so that we can provide for our families back at home. Yeah, so that at least our families can have food on the table, and also to make some few investments where we are. We've been working in this country. Personally, I've worked in this country for the last over 10 years. I've been an accountant here, and the pay has been very low. For crying out loud, we are going outside there, yeah, because in our contracts we've signed, we are going at least to get better pay than what we are getting back in the country. So all in all, I just want to urge all Kenyans and also youths who want job opportunities to go visit the accredited recruitment agencies like Competitive Manpower International, so that they can also get this chance and also provide for their families and the people back at home. Some of us, or even others after us, maybe might be disadvantaged because of negative publicity and propaganda that has been peddled by the media. At least they can give our youth chance, like me. I'm very happy because I'm also one of the I'll also be one of the product in Saudi Arabia. At least we can be accorded that chance so that we can go out, work, provide for people back at home, and at least with that our economy can also grow. Yeah, the requirements, first of all, you need to have a valid Kenyan passport. Number two, you need to have good conduct. It should be valid also from the government. Number three, we also go through a thorough medical examination from facilities that are being accredited by the Gulf countries. So I think we are well placed, because another thing, we also need better academic qualifications from the institutions back at home. I'm married. Oh, you can even see from my ring, I'm married. I've got a family, my wife, I've got four kids. And I'm going outside here at least to also provide for my family.